Hi my dear friends, welcome to my channel HSR BioInfo. In previous class we have discussed a few concepts regarding to the plasma membrane. Is it right? In the present class we are going to see one more important concept of plasma membrane, that is transport system. So, in the transport system of plasma membrane, how many transport systems of plasma membrane are present? Let us see, there is a two transport systems are present. One is a passive transport . Second one is a active transport. So, again passive transport divide into simple diffusion osmosis facilitated diffusion. Here, active transport divided into two types, primary active transport, secondary active transport. Again, primary active transport divided into two types, symport and co-transport. Here also it divided into two types, symport. Here is a uniport. So in this way, different types of transport systems which are present across the plasma membrane. This is the concept we are going to observe. Okay, let us start with the diagrammatical explanation. So, this is the plasma membrane. Plasma membrane, lipid layer 1 and lipid layer 2. We know very well. I am going to discuss the passive transport first. Then after, we will discuss secondary active transport and primary active transport and so on. So, here see simple diffusion. The diffusion, it means the movement of molecule from the one side of plasma membrane into the another side along or across the plasma membrane. Here one point to be noted, in the passive diffusion, all the molecules or all the mechanisms can depend on the concentration gradient. Then what is the concentration gradient? For example, here is a plasma membrane. Plasma membrane that contains the two sides. One side that contains the more solutes when compared to the another side. Then molecules from this side to this side, if they move, such a type of transport we called as a concentration gradient. The transportation of solutes according to the concentration gradient. In contrast, if the solutes from lower to the higher, such type of transport system we called as a concentration gradient. Similarly, if such molecules, solutes are the ions, then we called as a not a concentration gradient, it is a electrochemical gradient. See, electrochemical gradient, it means there is no concentration of the solutes. Here, higher concentration of the ions, which is present at the one place of the plasma membrane when compared to the another site. Such type of concentrations called as a electrochemical gradient. Electrochemical gradient. Here electrochemical gradient also done by the according to the electrochemical gradient, that is higher concentration to the lower concentration, higher electrochemical gradient to the lower electrochemical gradient, or against to the electrochemical gradient, that is also lower electrochemical gradient to the higher electrochemical gradient. This is the basic concepts we have to know. Let us see. Here in the simple diffusion, the carbon dioxide and oxygen, so on, hydrophobic non-polar materials that move from the one side of plasma membrane into the another side. Here, higher concentration to the lower concentration, that is simply called as according to the concentration gradient. So, this is all about the simple diffusion. Coming to the osmosis, osmosis can occur for the water, hydrophilic, polar moiety. Osmosis of water can also done through the plasma membrane according to the concentration gradient. It means high concentration of water that enter into the low concentration of water. Okay, that is called as a osmosis. Coming to the facilitated diffusion, here is a one difference. The facilitated diffusion, which utilizes the help of a proteins which embedded in the plasma membrane, such proteins we divided into the two types. One is the carrier proteins, second one is the channel proteins. First we see carrier proteins. For example, this is the carrier protein. Actually, the carrier proteins will carry the molecules or any solutes from the high concentration to the lower concentration. But one important point is, when solute binds to the one place of the carrier protein, it carries into the other place by changing its shape. By changing its shape like this, I will draw here. See the difference. Here outside of the carrier protein, there is a solute bind. Whereas here that solute can free from the carrier protein whenever it change its shape. Whenever it change its shape, this is a very peculiar point for the carrier proteins. So, this is a very important point to be noted. Coming to the channel proteins. Channel proteins are present in between the plasma membrane. These channel proteins forms the holes in between the proteins. This is called as a channel protein. This channel protein that contains the hole-like structure in between the two subunits of the protein. So, solutes from the one side, that is higher concentration to the lower concentration, can move very easily than the carrier proteins. This is the difference. Okay, in this way, different solutes from the one place that contains the higher concentration to the another place that contains the lower concentration, according to the concentration gradient, such type of transport we called as a passive transport. Passive transport. Okay, it is clear. Coming to the active transport. So, here I divided the active transport into the two main important points. Primary active transport, secondary active transport. Actually, the primary active transport, see here, for example, this is the plasma membrane. Primary active transport that utilizes the energy in the form of ATP. That utilizes the energy in the form of ATP, and also that utilizes a protein embedded in the plasma membrane. Such proteins we call as a pumps. Pumps. So they utilizing the pumps and utilizing the energy to transport moieties from the lower concentration to the higher concentration. That's the main important point to be noted here. Lower concentration to the higher concentration, that is against to the concentration gradient. Against to the concentration gradient. Let us see, in the primary active transport, uniport is there. Here, the uniport transfer a molecule, one single molecules, one type of single molecules from the lower concentration to the higher concentration with the help of the pumps. With the help of the pumps, that is called as a uniport. Uni means single. So, what it utilizing ATP as energy resources that converted into the ADP? That is simple. By conversion of ATP into ADP, one type of simple molecules that transported at the lower concentration to the higher concentration with the help of pumps, which is called as a uniport primary active transport. Coming to the co-transport. Co-transport is a sense here, it is also utilizes the pumps. Pumps are the proteins which are embedded in the plasma membrane. But which utilizes the ATP as an energy resources? That converted into the ADP. But here, the compound 1 and also compound 2. The compound 1 and compound 2 transport contrast to each other. That means, here the compound 1 at the lower concentration to the higher concentration in one direction, in this direction. At the same time, similar time, at the similar manner, the lower concentration compound number 2 transport in the opposite direction to the first compound from the lower concentration to the higher concentration. That is called as a co-transportation. Co means they both. At the same time, that is called as a co-transportation. So, this is called co-transportation. Okay, coming to the secondary active transport. So, secondary active transport that utilizes the carrier proteins instead of the pumps. These carrier proteins are very essential for the transportation of the antiport system and symport system. Let us see the symport system. Symport system here also, it is a active transport, that's why it transport the lower concentration to the higher concentration. Lower concentration to the higher concentration, but the two molecules from the lower concentration to the higher concentration. But it doesn't utilizes the ATP as energy resources. That is the important point to be noted here. It doesn't take any ATP for the transportation of two molecules in symport manner through the carrier proteins. So, that is the important. Coming to the antiport. Coming to the antiport. Secondary transport antiport that transfer the two molecules in the opposite direction. Two molecules in the opposite direction. Where actually secondary active transport transport the two molecules in the high concentration to the low concentration and low concentration to the high concentration. Here in the secondary active transport, that is not a concentration gradient. In the secondary active transport can done by the electrochemical gradient. I mentioned here in the secondary active transport electrochemical gradient, that means transportation of the ions. Transportation of the ions can occur along with the non-ionic material. For example, here one molecule is the ionic molecule that transfer from the one place to the another place. That such type of energy, electrochemical gradient contain the energy utilized by the another compound, that is also transport from the lower to the higher. Here also lower to the higher and higher to the lower, this is also done by the electrochemical gradient. In this way, complete system of transport which is present in the plasma membrane. Okay. Here, why transport system is very essential? What is the function of transport system? We know very well the digested food material that should be transferred from digested, completely digested part, that is small intestine microvilli, to the bloodstream. Such transportation also done by these mechanisms. And also, we know very well nerve impulses. Nerve impulses also depend upon the membrane potential. The membrane which contains the channels and membrane which contains the pumps, that pumps and channels which promote the potentiality of the membrane. If the nerve impulses start from one place, the membrane potential can change into the polarization, depolarization, repolarization, so on. I will discuss in the nerve impulses. Okay, in this manner, thus polarization, depolarization, these can be occurred only due to the transfer of moieties, transfer of ions like sodium, potassium from one place to the another place. So, such type of function also done by the plasma membrane. So, in this way, plasma membrane is very essential for the, not only this, plasma membrane maintains the calcium concentration within the cell and also maintain the many functions by transporting many moieties across the plasma membrane. So, simply plasma membrane, it maintaining the homeostasis of cell by transporting molecules from one place to the another place across the plasma membrane. This is a very simple manner. Okay, I hope this is a very simple to understand. You people understood this concept very easily. Please do subscribe my channel HSR by any.